Hey guys, you're watching Zoo on the Lonely. My name is AJ. Welcome back to another episode of Let's Build a Zoo. Today, it's going to be the beavers. That's my beaver impression. I want to do it over here because we've got this sort of path that leads around the outside of the penguin enclosure. I don't really know why I done it there in the first place, but I like it. And I thought, well, we need some sort of enclosures on this path now to fill it out. At least here. If I don't have any more enclosures, then I suppose I could just end the path off here and close it off that end, and then that's fine. But I think it's going to suit here, and we've got a lot of room to be able to do stuff. Oh yeah, I need to make that grass again. Now, with the beaver enclosure, I want to have a dam, which means we're going to have a waterfall, which means we're sort of going to have to, or a small waterfall, so we're going to have a lot of water. It'd be really cool as well if we could get, like, a fork in it, so it splits up into two somewhere. Even if we made two dams, that could be cool. Now, it needs to be somewhat large. Obviously, we don't want to make it unfairly large, but it'll probably end up being larger than some of the other enclosures. So let's say we do something like that. How tall? Two blocks tall is probably as high as we want to go. If we go any taller, it might look a little bit weird, right? So then we have... yeah. Then we have the river at the top here carved out. Like this. So it sort of starts, it originates here somewhere. What is what I want. So like some sort of pond bit here. And then the dam comes down. We should probably make that a little bit wider. Like that. This is where we'll have some logs and some stuff and try and make it as dam-like as possible. And then it drops down into here. I wonder if I could get another drop on it. If we could do like another drop here. Instead of doing a fork, just have like two dams instead. Oh, yeah, no, no, yeah. Hold on. We'll close this back up again. And instead of being going that way, we'll have it going this way. Yeah, like this. Just take out a bit of those. And then it comes around... back on itself again, back down here, and then drops down another block. Now we'll dress the outside area up. Let's not make it completely dead straight on either side, and we'll have something that looks like that. See, that's pretty cool. So it comes down there, around there, down, and then to like a little reservoir down here. I think around this area we probably want to drop down the ground at least sort of one or two blocks thick, so the beavers can get in and out of the water a little bit easier. It's also easier to see from the like spectating area as well. So we'll have something like that. Really, really cool. Now, I suppose we should put the water in and let it do its thing first, and then we'll change like little parts of the direction of the water afterwards. We're not going to be able to change all that much, because if you change it too much, it's going to not do what we want anymore. But I think if we do something like this, let's put the water in here. Just get a bit of a solid start to it, and then let it flow down. That's good. And then we go back to source block water down here. To about there. Oh, I think we need to go around the corner. Perfect. And then all of this is then sourced. Now all of this dirt will be changed to grass. It'll you know, grow itself, spread itself to grass eventually. That's already looking really cool. I like how gentle that one looks, and then how sharp that one looks. That's I've never sort of played with water that much in Minecraft, but that looks really cool. Let's now smoothen this out a little bit so it doesn't look like a big old square platform. That obviously wouldn't work for us. So we'll do something like that. Yeah, no, I think I'm okay. And then something like that. Couple along the front here. I sort of like that there. Boom. Boom. Okay. I like that. That's looking really nice. Obviously, we want grass, lots of sugar cane, lots of things like that. But let's go around the outside and make a little bit of a perimeter for ourselves now. So we definitely need it along here. That's not right. And we definitely need it around the back here. I want to give a little bit of room at the back of the dam. Maybe we can have some small collection of logs and stuff like that. That would be pretty cool to do. And then it's quite a large enclosure. It's not a small one, is it, for sure? You know, the wolf one in comparison is quite small. I suppose it's about twice as large as the wolf one, which doesn't really make any sense, but in a weird way. But I suppose for us to be able to do what we want to do in Minecraft, we need it to be a little bit bigger. I don't think the beavers need to be, like, fenced in with, like, 5-block-high fences. I think we can get away with just one fence block, or iron bars, so like 5 iron blocks high and stuff like that, or iron bars high. I think we can get away with one fence for the height. And I'm pretty sure even at the raised area, at this area, I don't think that they can get out. There they might be able to, yeah. As I said, I think you guys agreed with me in the fact that if mobs can't sprint, and I said last episode that if a mob can get out of the enclosure without sprinting, it means that, you know, that they can get out. But I don't think, even if you jump right at the edge, I don't think you could make that, even if I did do it properly. And the same up here. Yeah, I'm 99% sure that they can't get out there. So, we shall have a fence coming all the way around here. Some fallen oak trees would be cool. A couple stand... I want, like, two oak trees standing up. As in growing. And then some laying down. So, we're going to want to have sapling. And bone meal. And then we're going to want to have oak logs. And leaves. I think that's good. I don't think we want to use wood. Plank wood. We want to use log wood, don't we? So we'll have an oak tree here. And an oak tree here. And then I want to have... It'd be cool if we could have, like, an oak tree that sort of fell into the water a little bit. Just like a smidge like this. Be cool if Minecraft actually sort of changed, like the water changed depending on what was around it. Like if the water actually had physics, that would be really cool, wouldn't it? So like you could literally make a dam in Minecraft and the water. I know like the water sort of goes around like stuff, but like by putting something into the water, it makes the water level rise. Like if you have a bath and the bath is half full and then you get into the bath, the water level rises. It'd be really cool if Minecraft done something similar to that. That would be really cool. For the dams themselves, I think if we had something like that and that. See, it still goes through, but it looks pretty nifty. No, that doesn't then go through. What about like that? And then if we made that go that way. I want it to flow. Ah, like that. Then it'll flow. I should have not done that. No, it's going to always make it solid. Okay. That's not bad for a little miniature Minecraft dam. I think we can get away with that. It still sort of weaves through. And then the same up here. We probably want to have it like that. Like that. Like that. We'll do it like that. And maybe like that way instead. Just trying to get as many of them at different angles as possible. Okay, I think that's pretty cool. That's a pretty good looking beaver dam, right? You can see what, you can definitely see what it is. Now, we've got like a weird water situation. There we go. We want to have sugarcane and, more laying down trees. I should probably have like a tree over here that's fallen down. Like that. Just a little one on the end there. Maybe some random logs sort of around the place. I'm sticking with the oak logs and not going with other logs because I just think they look the best in this. It seems to be like the tree that the beavers would be able to get their hands on the easiest. We haven't got any specific biome around here, so having like spruce logs in my mind wouldn't make too much sense. Let's see if we can get like a couple of logs in the water as well. Yeah. Okay, I'm really liking this. Let's get some sugarcane around the side here. String to stop it from growing too tall on areas that we don't want it to grow tall on. There, there, and there. And then do some around the edge here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 1, 2. I see you. I see your true colors. Oh, I can't do it there. And there, there. Okay. So I think that's enough of that stuff. We then want to get some different leaves now. It'd be cool if we had some sort of darker leaves. Oh, they look pretty cool. Ogre lair leaves. That sounds so wrong, doesn't it? Ogre lair leaves. I think we can get away with using spruce leaves for like bushes around the water. Like that. Down here, we'll sort of let them sort of try and flow down a little bit, maybe. And over here. I think it's pretty cool how they sort of droop down and over the edge. A couple of little ones here. There. And there. Oh, no. Can't do any. Can't do them there. Yeah. Because of the fence. They can just get straight over this now, can't they? I mean, I could add another layer of fencing all the way. I think I will. You know, I think I'll just add another layer of fencing around the place to stop that from happening. Because I really like the logs that we've got. And I don't want to sort of keep the logs away from the fencing. We'll just add another fencing that goes around the side. That's what we'll do. All right, so have that there. Anything else? Oh. Lily pads, the ones I always forget about. We'll have one lily pad down there, a couple down here, and then a couple at the base, or one at the base. Boom, just one. Why do I keep placing so many? Don't go too crazy with them. It looks a little bit weird if you go too crazy. We'll get some lilacs, some nice pinky flowers to go around the outside. They're not my favorite, so I don't like to do too many of them, but they do just stand out really nicely here. Rosebush and fern. We'll grab the tall ones and the short ones. Let's go on with some rose bushes first. Try and keep them somewhat close to the river. Oops. There. And try not to do too many of them. Don't overdo it. We'll go around with some large ferns, small ferns as well. We'll do the large ones first. It's great. They don't have to be directly next to the water, but I just think they look they look better if they're somewhat close to the water most of the time. And then we'll go around with some small ones as well, just to fill up a few little spots that we want. So it doesn't need to be right next to the water. Somewhat nearby, I think that was good. And then we'll bone meal some of the other locations. Bone meal, just to get some long grass and stuff like that in some of the more plainer areas. Like here. Really nice. We're getting a lot of a good mix of different flowers and stuff going on here as well, which is cool. There and there. See, that looks like a really cool beaver enclosure, right? Let's just quickly nip around with I thought that was a little like worm on the floor or something, but it was just a string. Let's go around with another layer of fencing. Oh, I can't do that while standing on it. And then we'll put the beavers down. Now we're gonna have to watch the beavers for a couple of minutes because As I said, when I was reading in, well, I didn't really read into the mod because I don't like to sort of give away too much. I don't want to see pictures of the mobs that are in it. I sort of like to download it and just take a quick look. But then when we do like the video, when I show the mod off, I then like to go through all the animals. It just gives me so much inspiration on camera, and then I sort of know it. It gives you guys inspiration as well. But I did read that the beavers, it said something about collecting wood to make their own dams. Now, I don't know if that was just like describing what a beaver does or telling us what the beavers, what the mobs do themselves. Like, do they actually eat trees and chop down trees themselves and then move the wood like Enderman? Like, it's not, it wouldn't be that different or that difficult to code. I mean, a lot of the building blocks are all there. Enderman can already take blocks and move blocks. You know, they could do something like that where the beavers could like carry them and move them and place them down near water. I can't, you know, I can see someone being able to do that. So let's get some beavers down. Beaver. And they look just the cutest, don't they, with their little tail. Now they might just head. He likes the dam. They might just head straight for wood and just eat all the trees and all the wood in the area. Or they might move it. I don't know. It's what I sort of want to know. I've got to stick a few of them down so we have a higher percentage chance of something actually happening. But while they're sort of doing that, I think we need some kind of viewing platform. Although, yeah, you can see through and it looks really nice. You know, we can see the beavers through here. I think what would be better is if we got some kind of clay. I think hardened clay is a sort of a little bit of a standout color. And we made a little bit of a viewing platform for them, or a viewing station. Three blocks high, yeah. We'll make it nice and long because there's quite a lot to look at here. And 102. Replace air 102. Replace fence with 102. Hey there, little guy. How's it going, little guy? Are you okay? Are you okay? He's okay. Look at him. So, have they changed anything so far? That log's facing the wrong way. That's better. I remember all of that being the same. I remember all of that being the same. I almost think that was like that, but I might be wrong. I don't think it was actually. I like that better though. So if that was like that, then I'm gonna be good. Okay, they're all collecting up in the corner. Oh, they seem to be following each other almost as well. I don't know, maybe they're checking out that tree that's on the ground, or maybe they are just clumping up in this area. We know that some mobs do that. We know that some mobs. What was that? There was something red over here. I'm sure there was something red that was flying over here. Go back in the video like a few seconds while I was over there looking this way. I'm sure I saw something red that was flying. Might have been wrong. I swear I saw it out of the corner of my eye. It was just like there somewhere, right on my cursor. It was like something spawned and then instantly despawned. I don't know. Oh no, they're all going back again. Maybe they just sort of got a little bit confused. So we do know that with some AI, they do seem to clump up in certain areas. But these seem to be relatively spread out at the moment. Hey there, little guy. Hey. Are you okay? Are you okay? Oh, I made him jump. All right then, well, I suppose that's gonna do it for this episode, guys. If you enjoyed it, hit that like button. If you haven't already, then feel free to subscribe. We'll see you in the next episode.